Welcome back, and fans, guys. Man, this is crazy. This is absolutely baffling. The Giant has stepped in, has sighted now. You saw it with Hollywood Hogan in the black and white. And we've been asking why. We've been asking so many questions. Here's the big question. What about the tag team match this Sunday? The Giant and Sting together against Hall and Nash of the Wolfpack. Sting again and the Giant together. Can that really happen now?
You're asking me? I should ask you. No one seems to know anything. I can't get an answer from anybody. Don't ask me. I don't know what's going on there. The NWO is gone. They're snapped. There's something. I don't know.
Millions of wrestling fans coast to coast.
Whoa.
I think we just witnessed everyone's jaw dropped with that shocking announcement of the Giant joining Hollywood Hogan in the NWO. How are Sting and the Giant going to be able to coexist as a team?
First of all, Mike, what could they have offered him? What could they have offered him to make him join the NWO? What possible amount of money? What promises? What could they offer this man? Why would you do something like that?
It's a stunner.
He's been there. He's been a part of the NWO once.
He knows what they're about.
You know, we talked about the dividing lines, who would go with whom, but never in our wildest dreams that we think the Giant would do this. What about the tag match? What about Sting? Hopefully we can answer those questions during the course of this telecast. All right. Take a deep breath here. We need to talk now about another jerk, Chris Jericho. And here's what happened 1 week ago on this program. Take a look.
Once again, I would like to dedicate my performance tonight to this man right here, Dean Malenko. When I think of how you dedicated to your career, to your late father, one thing pops in my head. Your father must be rolling in his grave. You're a disgrace to your family, Malenko. You're a failure. You could never wrestle. Your brother sure can't wrestle, and your father certainly can't wrestle. And you call your mediocre career a tribute? You call it a dedication? I call it an immense joke. I, too, have someone I'm dedicating my career to. He's a man who knows one more hold than you do, Dean. He knows one hold. He's a much better ring technician than you. That's not saying much. And he's a lot more exciting than you, which also isn't saying much. Ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to introduce to you, Mr. Boris Malenko, coming down the aisle. Let's hear it for Boris. Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Boris. Let's have a big round of applause for the Boar Man himself, Mr. Boris Malenko.
Right here, Jericho putting on some heavy-duty pressure.
Sidewalk slam into the Lion Tamer, and Chris Jericho gets the win over this opponent who I refuse to name.
Well, it was obvious this young man was in on the ploy from the start.
Sure he was.
But now even Jericho abuses him and wins with the Lion Tamer.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, joining me at this time, the Cruiserweight Champion of the World, Mr. Chris Jericho. This man has really been on a roll, a tear, if you will, in recent weeks. And the latest issue, I believe, Chris Jericho, is there's nobody to challenge you for the Cruiserweight title.
Well, you know, Mean Gene, first of all, I would like to meet everybody here. Welcome to Monday Night Jericho! Second of all, Gene, I'd like you to refer to me by my proper name, Lionheart Chris Jericho, man of 1,004 holds, the Ayatollah of rock and roll, and true paragon of virtue for the entire free world.
You can do me a favor. If you could get that to me in a memo, I'll be more than happy to do so.
You know, Gene, I'm the greatest cruiserweight champion of all time. I've acquired masks. I've acquired mahi-mahis. I've acquired the knee of Rey Mysterio Jr., which I feel very, very bad about. And, Gene, the bottom line is this. There's no one else for me to face. I've done all I can do. So after tonight's performance, I'm going to take this belt. I'm going to retire it because nobody can ever, ever beat me for this belt.
All right. Chris Jericho, I think you may have counted on some things that are not going to come to pass. Please, this tie is mine. If you want it, I'll buy you one.
Gene, first of all,
Wait a minute. Once again on the scene, Chairman of the Executive Committee, J.J. Dillon, I'm certain you've overheard this very interesting conversation.
I apologize for the interruption, but, Mr. Jericho, I think any announcement about retiring the title might be a little bit premature. Now, granted, you have taken on all of the top contenders, and you have defeated all of them. However, what you're not aware of is that the Executive Committee has already signed for Slamboree this Sunday 15 of the top cruiserweights in the world to meet in a battle royal at Slamboree.
Wait a minute, that's news to me, JJ. When did you let the cat? Is this it? Is this the announcement?
It was just signed, and the prize to the winner is that they will then challenge you for the cruiserweight title at Slamboree.
Wow. On the very same night, I can't believe
wow.
it.
Wow. What are you talking about?
The table is set for that one.
Wait a minute, Gene. You're telling me that 14 men are going to be... After this one man has been beaten by 14 men, he's been pummeled, he's been destroyed, then I get to face him?
The man that survives the battle royal is the man that'll challenge you.
Those are good odds. I'll take it. Before I leave, Mean Gene, I'd just like to say I want to dedicate the rest of my career to this man, a true man of respect, a man of...
What have you done? Somebody has defaced this picture of Gene Malenko. I got a sneaking suspicion it was you.
I left this thing alone for 5 seconds in the dressing room. Who did this to my picture of Dean Dean?
Well, I've seen what you've done in the weeks before this, and certainly whoever is a lousy artist, I must say that.
That's horrible. You know what this does to me? Who did this? I want names. I'm going to get to the bottom of this. This is a disgrace. This is a fallacy.
Wait a minute. Chris Jericho, you did this, did you not?
That's Dean Malenko's brother, isn't it?
Wait a minute. That is his
hey,
brother.
Hey, it's Joe Malenko.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is Dean Malenko's brother, Joe Malenko. They teamed at one time. Wait a minute.
Take it easy, Joe. This has nothing to do with you. This is between me and your little bro. I got no problems with you, Shooter. I got no problems at all.
Coming from the great wrestling Malenko family, certainly you have got to take exception to this picture and what he said about your brother.
Jericho, you're the Energizer Bunny of poor taste, little man.
I'll go along with that.
You came on here last week, and you disrespected my dad, my brother, and me. When I was in the game, we understood that when people retired from this business after putting in their time and paying their dues, that they got respect from the younger boys. And you are...
You're missing the point, Joe. I have no disrespect towards you at all. I love your brother. I have the utmost respect for him and for you and for your family. Everything's been misconstrued.
What about what you said about his late father, the great Boris Malenko?
It was all a misconstrued... The truth is, Joe, I have nothing against you, nothing against your family. As a matter of fact, you want to end this now? You want to take the picture and walk out of here? I'll let it lie. I'll leave it. It will never, ever happen again, I promise.
Why don't you take it and just go, Joe? We can leave it at that. Huh? He'll take it. That's it? Okay, fine. Get away from this. I don't care for anything. Hey, Gogo, get out of here.
Hey! Boy, didn't you know? Oh, didn't you know this was coming? Disgraces the picture. Disgraces the entire Malenko family. Joe had been watching these programs along with millions of fans. He knew what was going down, and he was sick of it, and so are we. We're going to step out on Jericho and come back with more on Nitro.